Hi, Jeannie Patel Thompson here. I am the international best-selling author of this book, Listen to Your Gut, the Complete Natural Healing Program for IBS and IBD. I also am the author of the IBD Remission Diet, which I wrote way back in 1999. And that was when I myself had a massive colonic hemorrhage and wanted to heal it without using any drugs or surgery whatsoever, and went on a search for what else there might be. So I will tell you that story in a separate video. Right now, I want to get into the top Q&A for people on elemental diets, because I have, I don't even know how many long in-depth videos on every aspect and every piece of an elemental diet. They're an hour to an hour and a half long. And I understand that people do not have the time to sit and watch the whole thing. So what I'm doing with this video series is I'm chunking it up into the top Q&As I have received from my 250,000 readers over the last two decades. So let's get started. First of all, the number one Q&A that I get regarding an elemental diet is, how do I know if I don't tolerate the product, or if it's simply the healing process or the nature of an elemental diet? All right, so let's talk about a few things. First of all, so this is the product that I formulated, Absorb Plus. There's a vegan version, there's a free form amino acid version. You know, I'm so bad with these. I'm just gonna put pictures up from now on. I can't hold the products. So you wanna choose the version of the product according to what you already know about your body's tolerances, right? So there's also, with Absorb Plus, there's a whey isolate version. Now, the interesting thing about whey isolate, don't confuse it with concentrate. It has only the isolate whey protein, no casein, no lactose. So it's a lot more easily tolerated than normal dairy products, okay? The vegan version is sprouted brown rice protein with an additional free-form amino acid blend. The Absorb Plus Amino is only free-form amino acids. So we're talking about protein sources here. Now, what's ideal is if you can rotate between two or three versions, because then, let's say you need to go on an elemental diet for 6 or 7 weeks. I actually have people who've been on Absorb Plus for 2 years. They have a doctor's notice for it that goes to their insurance company saying that this is all they can eat. This is the only food source they tolerate. Without it, they'll die. So they get it covered by their insurance. And they have eaten nothing but Absorb Plus for 2 years. And they're, I don't think it's a good idea. I think they're actually frightened of moving on to other foods. I think if that were me, I would get some one-on-one support and try to start moving forward in the healing journey, trying to integrate easily well-tolerated foods. But it just goes to show that you absolutely can. I also have another reader who, during her entire pregnancy, because she went into a flare soon after she became pregnant, she consumed nothing but Absorb Plus elemental shakes with some raw vegetable juicing, just in whatever amount she could tolerate, because as anyone knows, raw juicing can trigger a lot of people into diarrhea, then you're into nutrient loss. It's not a net win. So you have to wait till your digestive capability comes up a little bit, which Absorb Plus elemental shakes can help you do. Of course, you can use other elemental shake products that are, there are a lot more available now than when I came up with my formula. So go ahead and try those. If you like them better, have at it. The information I'm giving you is applicable to any elemental shake product, as long as it adheres to the same guidelines, which are no added fats. If you have fats sprayed onto the powder in any form, you don't have control over your fat tolerance. That's number one. And you don't have control over the type of fat you're adding. And for me and many of my readers, when you first start on an elemental diet, you may not tolerate any fat at all. So this answers the question of, am I intolerant? Is it a healing process? So first thing that I would do is get an elemental shake product that has zero added fat. Then when you feel like, okay, I'm doing well on this product alone, Then start adding in the fat of your choice. And you've got to test these. Like people go like, oh, MCT oil from coconuts is like the best elemental fat. No, there's a ton of people who can't tolerate coconut oil or MCT oil. So for those people, flaxseed oil, but it has to be cold pressed. It has to be organic, right? Cold pressed flax oil or Udo's Choice oil. It's a blend of a bunch of different oils. Those are the two oils that we have found like over two decades for people to have the highest tolerance with. So when you are ready to start adding in a fat, you start with like half a teaspoon, maybe a quarter teaspoon if you know that you're super fat intolerant, and then you gradually add it in. Okay, second issue that you might want to address, in fact, I strongly recommend you address, is your gut flora. So usually a lot of the reason you're going on an elemental diet is because your gut flora, your mucosal lining are not healthy, they're not balanced. So what I recommend for my readers in the IBD Remission Diet book, put it there, bing, is to start on what I've called Genie's Wild Oregano Oil Protocol. So wild oregano is a broad spectrum antipathogen, kills bacteria, fungi, yeast, and some parasites. It'll also kill a bacterial fungal hybrid called MAP, Mycobacterium avium paratuberculosis, which has been found in, depending on the study, up to 95% of people with Crohn's disease. So, and this is something that has a 2-year active dormant life cycle. Okay, not gonna get distracted, not gonna go off on another topic, sticking with today's Q&A. It's so hard for me, guys. Honestly, it's so hard for me not to like segue off into other important things, but I'm doing my best here, Okay. So starting on the wild oregano oil, we hit it hard 3 to 5 times a day, but at nighttime, before you go to bed, you take a high dose of Natron brand probiotics. And yes, unfortunately, that is the only brand of probiotics I can recommend still 20 years later. And I have asked my readers, if you find another probiotic manufacturer that meets the selection criteria for a therapeutic grade probiotic, please let me know. I was hoping Germany would come up with something because they're usually pretty rigorous, but it's just not happening. And people are putting soil organisms. Okay. Diverting off into another topic, not going to do it, staying on track. Okay, so you're doing your wild oregano 3 to 5 times a day, hitting it hard. And then a night before you go to bed, you're doing the high dose Natron probiotics. This keeps your gut flora in check. It's killing pathogens all day long, and then it's implanting with healthy bacteria at night. So that is something that can hugely reduce any adverse reactions that you're having on an elemental diet, because it is supporting the foundation of what you're trying to shift and what you're trying to achieve. So third point, your common signs of food allergy and intolerance are fatigue, headaches, brain fog, bloating, gas, and of course, any exacerbation in symptoms. Here's where it gets tricky. What are the symptoms of die-off? Because as you improve your bacterial flora, the bad bacteria and the candida yeast organisms and whatever other yeasties you got in there are gonna die. Now, candida alone releases 168 different toxins as it dies. It's like, goodbye, leaving you my goodbye present. Here you are. That is a massive toxin dump. And guess what those toxins produce? Bloating, gas, fatigue, diarrhea, brain fog, headaches. I mean, they're almost indistinguishable. So the only way you can distinguish is to stick with it or listen to your gut, because your body wisdom actually knows whether you're having a Herxheimer die-off reaction or whether you're having an intolerance. So I would say your number one thing for healing anything, anytime, is to improve your intuition, improve your intuitive ability, your ability to listen to your gut. So I have some guided audios on my site, but there's tons of instructors teaching intuition development, psychic awareness, animal communication, call it what you want. they're all along that same spectrum of connecting to a deeper, greater wisdom. So you've got that point of how to distinguish between the Herxheimer and an actual intolerance. Give it time. Probably, I would say 7 to 10 days, Herxheimer's done, then you can check for intolerance. Of course, if you get a strong gut feeling during that time, switch to a different one. The most highly hypoallergenic formula is an exclusively free-form amino acid formula. Pop it up here. That's your best bet. So switch to a free-form amino acid that is the most highly non-allergenic, hypoallergenic version that you can try. The next most highly tolerated would probably be a vegan formula. But again, it depends on your genetics, because if you have the Absorb Plus only contains sprouted brown rice protein, because brown rice is the most tolerated plant protein source. A lot of others contain pea and bean and other types of things, but then you're increasing your likelihood of having an intolerance to it. A lot of people from various genetic backgrounds don't tolerate beans, for example, and peas fall in that category. So again, kind of know what your body already is good with and not, and you know, match that up with the protein source. So the other thing you'll notice if you're having gas and bloating as your main symptom, know this: every elemental formula is like breast milk. Now think of a breastfed baby and think of their lovely little round baby belly. That's what happens to you. I've gone on an elemental diet for various reasons, you know, 4 or 5 times. Every single time I look like I'm 4 months pregnant. My belly just comes right out because it is a pre-digested food source, very similar to breast milk. And that's just how the body reacts. Now, some people are lucky. Some people do not have that reaction. That's awesome. Some people will even, instead of producing the bloating, which leads to the liquid stools, which you think are diarrhea, but they're not, they're just, you're eating a liquid. Think again, breastfed baby. Is there stool formed? Hell no, it's liquid. So that's what you're getting on an elemental diet. But there are some people who go the other way. So they will go to constipation. Their body will just suck up everything. They'll get a little bit constipated from the carbohydrate, which is in Absorb Plus, it's organic tapioca maltodextrin. You can also, if you're gonna use corn maltodextrin, make sure it's non-GMO. Do not consume something that is not certified non-GMO corn, because that alone is gonna damage your gut. Their body just sucks that up and becomes a little bit constipated. So in that case, your cure for that is just to add, say, start with 125 milligrams of magnesium citrate to your elemental shake, and then drink a full glass of water in between shakes, which I actually recommend for everybody, and see how that works. If it's not quite enough to balance out that constipation, up the magnesium, 250 milligrams, you can safely go up to 1,000 milligrams a day. So, you know, space that out in your shakes until you hit the place where your bowels are moving normally and in a way that you like. So I believe I have covered everything for that Q&A. And I hope this has helped you, and join me for the next one. I'm going to shoot these in a series, so it makes you really easy to scan on YouTube or wherever to do a keyword search for whatever your question is that's coming up at that time. Thanks for joining me.